Note, all of the mutilations, bodily dismemberments, and cannibal rituals were performed by seasoned professionals. Please do not attempt any of these stunts at home. Thank you.
The dead return to life, living and lusting for bizarre pleasures. Fantastic fiends on a bloody rampage.
After that, Ezra made many visits to the graveyard, bringing home bodies, or parts of bodies, to keep his mother and himself company. He was a ghoul, a necromaniac, a defiler of the dead. But he had not yet turned his sickness on a living victim. It was only a matter of time until he did.
Out of the door. screaming savage blood death. What kind of madness would profit from the helpless victims already endured to their final peace?
Ladies and gentlemen, have you ever seen the sight of human butchery in person?
Together, I'll strangle you with your own guts.
Yeah! gonna beat a worm face.
I'm the first. Zombies, exploding heads, creepy crawlies, and a date for the formal.
I reach in your brain and pull your fucking soul out and throw it on the floor.
Over the crowd. Let it be known, sons and daughters, that Satan was an acid head. Drink from his cup. Pledge yourselves. And together we'll all freak out.
Yeah. Say, what do you make of these murders, Frank? He always kills the same way. He just takes one part of the body. This time, he took the brains. Now, what kind of a creature would do that?
Down. Below the legend, we got it. There's much to warn us all of the trends our destiny is taking. Our scientists agree that the one immutable law of life is change. There's much talk and protests about everything, about pollution, about drugs and their abuse. And this has been a story based partly on fact, partly on probability. But the horrors that occur in the minds of those who allow the indiscriminate use of the human body as a mixing bowl for drugs and chemicals are as real as the real horror. So when you eat or take into your body any chemical or drugs, you take a chance on reactions that are untested, unpredictable. There are government agencies, many responsible groups, fighting the use of chemicals in the food we eat, the water we drink. And yet there are far too many of us who go right on taking the good way of life for granted, ignoring the warnings. So, let's give a little thought to making our own story have a happy ending. Ha ha ha!